Hey everyone! Diving into the whirlwind that surrounds Omid Scobie's latest release, Endgame, it's like the jury's still out on whether Harry and Meghan, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, are winning or losing the public's heart. Welcome to a discussion that's as heated as it gets in royal circles. Today, I've stumbled upon some fascinating reads that are on opposite ends of the spectrum concerning the Sussex's latest narrative chapter. It's intriguing, really, because Endgame was bound to stir the pot. Regarding how we see Meghan and Harry, but it's turning into a real puzzle whether it's casting them in a favorable light or not. I'm leaning towards the notion that this might not play out well for them in the long run. Think about it. Harry and Meghan have been under fire for their outspoken critics of royal life, and Endgame just adds fuel to the fire. Critics haven't been kind to what they're dubbing Scobie's Scooby-Doo-Doo narrative, and it doesn't seem like it'll do the Sussexes any favors moving forward. But let's not just take my word for it. Angela Levin, a name synonymous with royal analysis, recently shared her insights with GB News, and it's worth noting. The headline grabbing everyone's attention? Meghan Markle might be dropped by talent agency over Omid Scobie's new book. Levin, who's had her finger on the pulse of royal dynamics for years and has been openly critical of Meghan and Harry's actions, hinted at a possible fallout for Meghan with her talent agency, William Morris Endeavor. According to her conversation with Patrick Christie's on GB News, the agency is on edge about the Endgame aftermath even before the book's release, given the controversial leaks and revelations swirling around. It's a dicey situation, and the anticipation surrounding the book's impact on the Sussex brand is palpable. Stay tuned as we delve deeper into the saga and what it means for Meghan and Harry's standing with the public and their professional circles. So, the plot thickens with the release of Omid Scobie's Endgame, and things have taken a turn for the chaotic, especially after the Dutch version dropped some major bombshells. Let's dive into the drama that's got everyone talking. Before the book even hit the shelves, there were whispers and leaks hinting at some pretty explosive content, including allegations and stories about the royal family that raised more than a few eyebrows. But the real shocker came when the Dutch edition of Endgame went a step further by naming the royal family members who allegedly made remarks about Archie's skin color before he was born. This revelation was a curveball because both Scobie and the Sussexes had previously been tight-lipped about identities, citing concerns over legal repercussions and the potential damage to the individuals named. Now, Harry and Meghan had been adamant about keeping these names under wraps. Harry swore he'd never tell, and Meghan mentioned it would be too damaging. Yet somehow, these names found their way into not just the Dutch, but reportedly the Belgian edition, and possibly even the Italian and Spanish versions. Scobie, on his end, seems to be playing the blame game, pointing fingers at translators and publishers, but the consensus among skeptics is that this move was no accident. Critics argue it smells like a calculated attempt to drum up publicity and boost sales for what they deem an otherwise lackluster book. The question on everyone's lips is, what's going to be the fallout from this bombshell? Amidst all this, Harry and Meghan have stayed silent on the matter, not offering any denials or distancing themselves from the book, which to many signals implicit involvement. After all, where else would Scobie get such intimate details? And as for the implications, the controversy has reignited discussions around race and the royal family, putting the Sussexes and their relationship with the rest of the royals back under the microscope. It's a tangled web of who said what and the motivations behind these revelations, leaving the public and royal watchers eager to see how this saga will unfold. In the wake of the recent controversies stirred by Omid Scobie's Endgame, there's buzzing speculation around Meghan Markle's standing with her talent agency, Double Me. Some are whispering that this could be the straw that breaks the camel's back, leading to her potential drop from the agency. Given the stormy climate, it wouldn't be surprising if WME were on the lookout for a graceful exit. Meghan's aspirations in Hollywood haven't quite taken off as anticipated. Despite the initial fanfare when she signed with WME, the expected blockbuster projects haven't materialized. Critics argue that her marketability is waning, suggesting that any project she touches might not fare well, hinting at a pattern of high-profile ventures not living up to their hype. According to Angela Levin, quoted in conversations with GB News, the situation is more dire than it appears. Levin suggests that WME is more than just concerned about the fallout from Scobie's book. They're reassessing their relationship with Meghan. The agency's apparent horror isn't just at the book's revelations, but at the broader implications for Meghan's brand. Levin's remarks hint at a critical juncture for Meghan, with her agency reportedly urging her to dial back the grievances, hinting that her public image is souring relationships and making their job all the more challenging. This narrative puts Meghan in a precarious position. Once heralded as a breakout star destined for Hollywood success, her journey has been anything but straightforward. Despite a stint on Suits, her transition to royalty and back to the entertainment world hasn't been the fairy tale comeback story many anticipated. Critics, like those voicing their opinions freely on the matter, argue that Meghan's current fame leans more towards notoriety, overshadowing her work and potential contributions to the entertainment industry. Support for Meghan, however, isn't entirely extinct. She still holds a loyal fan base, the Squad, who continue to back her despite the controversies, yet the overarching sentiment suggests a tough road ahead, with industry insiders and observers alike questioning her future moves and her ability to reclaim a positive spotlight in Hollywood in the whirlwind of opinions swirling around Meghan Markle's future in Hollywood. It's clear that her path to regaining the spotlight is fraught with challenges. The release of Endgame has stirred the pot even more, leading to speculation about her standing with the talent agency WME. The conversation is not just about whether she can secure roles, but about the nature of those roles and her perceived marketability in the entertainment industry. During a discussion with Angela Levin, as reported by GB News, the possibility of Meghan being dropped by her agency was brought up, emphasizing the uphill battle she faces in achieving the level of stardom she desires. Levin points out that Meghan might not be willing to settle for the smaller roles that are realistically within her reach, considering her aspirations for leading roles that match her newfound status post-royalty. The harsh truth, as Levin sees it, is that Meghan's acting prowess and appeal may not align with the lofty expectations she has set for herself. Patrick Christie's musings on whether Meghan could still be viewed as an asset by her agency, given the potential financial rewards, were met with skepticism by Levin. She argues that Meghan's need for public adoration and her continuous embroilment in scandals make her a less than ideal candidate for projects looking for a surefire hit. An insider, speaking to The Express, highlighted the dismay within Meghan's talent team and WME at the ongoing controversies surrounding her. This sentiment suggests that any potential deals that might be in the works could be jeopardized by the negative publicity. The predicament here is that companies are wary of associating with someone whose personal and public issues could overshadow their project or brand, making Meghan a risky investment. As the debate rages on about Meghan's future in Hollywood and her relationship with WME, it's evident that her path is not as straightforward as once thought. The fallout from Endgame and the continuous public scrutiny seem to have compounded the challenges she faces, making her next moves in the entertainment industry all the more critical to watch. In a turn of events that's as surprising as it is contentious, there's chatter in the air about Prince Harry and Meghan, Markle's popularity experiencing a bit of a resurgence, thanks in part to the latest literary offering from Omid Scobie, Endgame. This development seems to be raising eyebrows across the board, with many wondering how the Sussex's image is navigating the stormy seas stirred up by their very public departure from royal duties. According to an expert quoted by The Express, there's a buzz that Harry and Meghan's favor with the public might be on an upswing. This notion seems almost paradoxical, given Scobie's portrayal of the couple in what some might call an excessively flattering light, which could potentially backfire in terms of credibility. Yet the claim has sparked a mix of skepticism and curiosity about the dynamics at play. On the flip side, the royal family, often referred to as the firm, appears unshaken by the renewed spotlight on the Sussexes' exit saga. It's business as usual for them, showcasing their trademark resilience and unity in the face of controversy. The royal family continues to engage in their duties with poise, recently evidenced by their presence at the prestigious White Tie diplomatic reception at Buckingham Palace. This event, featuring key royal figures like King Charles, Queen Camilla, Prince William, and Princess Catherine, dominated headlines, steering the narrative away from the Sussexes' legal battles and back to the monarchy's ongoing engagements. This juxtaposition of the Sussexes' purportedly rising popularity against the backdrop of the royal family's steadfast demeanor presents a fascinating study in contrast. It underscores the complex and ever-evolving relationship between public figures and their audience, highlighting the delicate balance between personal revelations and public perception. In an intriguing twist of narrative, discussions around Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's standing with the public have taken a new turn. Amidst the backdrop of Omid Scobie's controversial endgame, a royal commentator on GB News threw in a perspective that's been causing quite a stir. The commentator, Ms. Hodgson, boldly stated that the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's popularity might be on the rise. Once again, a statement that has left many scratching their heads in wonder. Ms. Hodgson's comments came as something of a surprise, especially considering the recent turbulence surrounding Harry and his ongoing legal skirmishes in the UK, not to mention the lack of any public response from Meghan and Harry regarding the revived discussions on racial issues triggered by Endgame, captured by paparazzi in a parking lot. Recently, Meghan's appearance did little to suggest a burgeoning wave of public support, leaving the source of Hodgson's optimism somewhat mysterious. Delving deeper, Hodgson noted the complex situation Harry finds himself in, particularly with the British media, where his standing appears to be more in the realm of notoriety than favor. This observation raises eyebrows, juxtaposing the idea of rising popularity with the reality of their current public engagements and the nature of media coverage they're receiving. Hodgson also touched on the lack of positive or uplifting news coming from the Sussex camp, suggesting that while Harry might have expected sympathy for his privacy concerns, public interest seems to be waning. This viewpoint aligns with the broader sentiment that without a steady stream of constructive or affirmative actions, garnering increased support could be challenging for Meghan and Harry. The juxtaposition of Hodgson's initial claim of the Sussexes' rising popularity against her subsequent observations presents a complex picture. It reflects the nuanced and often contradictory landscape of public opinion, where the Duke and Duchess remain figures of intense debate and discussion. As they navigate these turbulent waters, the royal family continues to maintain their composure, focusing on their duties and presenting a united front amid the ongoing media frenzy. In the latest chapter of the ongoing saga that surrounds the British royal family and the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, opinions are as varied as they are vocal. Among those sharing their thoughts, Andy Jones, a panelist cited by The Express, has been particularly forthright in his support for the monarchy, echoing a sentiment that seems to be growing among certain sections of the public. Jones, who admits to previously being ambivalent about the royals, finds himself increasingly in their corner, especially in light of recent criticisms, his transformation from a casual observer to a staunch defender of the likes of Charles, Kate, and William is noteworthy. "The more they get attacked, the more defensive I become," Jones explained, highlighting a shift in his perspective. Influenced in part by the attacks leveled against the royal family by figures such as Omid Scobie, and indirectly by Harry and Meghan themselves. This rallying around the royal family isn't just a personal journey for Jones. It reflects a broader trend where adversity seems to be reinforcing loyalty among the British public. The royal family's adherence to their never complain, never explain approach amidst these turbulent times is winning them admiration, even from those who once viewed the institution with skepticism. The narrative around Harry and Meghan's actions appears to contribute to this phenomenon. Their outspokenness, perceived by some as petty or unjust, inadvertently cast the royal family in a more favorable light, underscoring their dignity and grace under fire. Amidst these discussions of loyalty and defense, Prince Harry's legal battle over his family's security arrangements in the UK adds another layer to the complex dynamics at play. Since stepping back from royal duties, Harry's insistence on security for his family during UK visits has been a contentious issue. His legal challenge against the decision made by the Executive Committee for the Protection of Royalty and Public Figures, RAVIK, in February 2020, to alter the security provisions for him and his family, underscores the ongoing challenges and public debates surrounding the Sussexes and their relationship with the royal family and the British establishment. In a development that's been stirring considerable debate across the UK, Prince Harry has found himself at the center of a legal tussle that's as controversial as it is costly. Following the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's decision to step back from their roles as senior members of the royal family, they were informed that their security arrangements would consequently change. This decision, understandably, did not sit well with them, particularly with Harry, who believes that his birthright and position as the son of the king entitles him to the same level of security as other royals. This disagreement has led Harry to challenge the decision through legal means, arguing for the necessity of police protection. Last July, he achieved a partial victory when the High Court allowed him to challenge its initial ruling against automatic police protection, citing procedural unfairness. This legal battle, however, comes with a hefty price tag, estimated to be around $1 million, a sum that sparked outrage given the current economic climate and the cost of living crisis facing the UK. The public discourse around this issue is intense, with opinions divided on the justification of Harry's legal actions versus the financial burden it imposes on taxpayers. This saga, coupled with the controversies surrounding the publication of Omid Scobie's Endgame, has led to speculation about the long-term implications for Harry and Meghan's relationship with the rest of the royal family. As we continue to navigate these turbulent waters, the question remains, will Endgame bolster the Sussexes' popularity, or could it indeed be the final nail in the coffin for their royal relations, with the potential of royal titles being stripped and the ongoing legal battles, the saga of Harry and Meghan is far from over. And as this story unfolds, it's sure to keep us all watching closely to see what the future holds for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. And that wraps up our dive into the latest twists and turns in the ongoing saga of the British royal family. From legal battles to public opinion shifts, it's clear that the narrative surrounding Harry, Meghan, and the institution they've stepped back from is as complex as ever. As we keep an eye on these developments, remember, the story of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex and their relationship with the royal family continues to evolve, bringing new insights and debates to the fore. It's been great having you with us for this discussion. Your thoughts and perspectives enrich the conversation, so feel free to share your take on these unfolding events. Here's to staying informed and engaged with the stories that captivate us, wishing you a wonderful day ahead and looking forward to our next exploration together.